In this video, we're going to cover a few more topics about transformations, notably freezing, resetting, and storing transform values. Freezing transformations in Maya does pretty much the same thing as it does in Softimage. When you choose Modify Freeze Transformations, it sets the object's transformations to the origin while keeping the object's current pose. If you want to select specific transformation types to freeze, open the Options box, select the options, and then click Freeze Transform. You can also choose these commands from the Channels Freeze menu in the Channel box. The difference between Softimage and Maya is that when you freeze an object in Softimage, the object center goes to the origin. Whereas in Maya, you'll notice that the object's pivot stays in place. We'll talk about Maya's object pivot in more detail in the next video, but you can open the attribute editor and expand the pivot section on the Transform tab to see how freezing adjusts the values for the pivot. If you change the pivot values back to 0, you'll get the same behavior as in Softimage. Or you can choose Modify Reset Transforms to reset all the transforms, which moves the pivot to the origin. You can see that the transform values are still zeroed out. As with freezing transforms, you can open the Options box to reset specific transformation types. If you reset the transforms, but it doesn't seem to work properly, make sure to check some of the options in the tool settings, such as the rotate pivot, as these settings are persistent across Maya sessions. The problem could also be that the number of decimal places you're using for the transform values in the channel box isn't high enough, as described in the previous video, Basic Transformations in Maya. Remember that the values in the hidden decimal places are still considered in the calculation. Let's say that you've frozen the transforms for an object a number of times, and now you want to get back to a previous frozen state or to the original transforms. What do you do? Your first inclination might be to delete the construction history, which deletes all operations in an object's history and is pretty much a one-way ticket. Instead of doing this, you can use the node editor to see the node graph of all operations for that object. If you click the Inputs/Outputs icon, you can see all the nodes for this object. You can then delete the most recent transform nodes to get back to the frozen state that you want, or delete all the transform nodes to return to the original state. For more information about the node graph, see the video Understanding Maya's Dependency Graph on this channel. In relation to freezing transform values is the neutral pose in Softimage, which was designed to work with non-geometric rig controls whose transforms cannot be frozen. Basically, you create a pose for your rig, then set a neutral pose which seems to freeze the transformation values. It actually stores the rig control's current values as an extra offset that gets applied between the parent and the object's own transform, so that all you need to do is zero out the object's transform to return to this pose. Just be aware that there isn't really an equivalent of the neutral pose in Maya. However, you can save an object's attribute values on the Transform tab as a preset for a pose, just as you can with attributes on the other tabs. Saving attribute presets is similar to saving property page presets in Softimage. Click the Preset button and choose Save Transform Preset, then give it a name. The presets list shows all attribute presets you've saved for any object, so make sure to use a descriptive name. All attribute presets are saved as MEL scripts in your Maya Presets folder. To apply a preset, select one from the presets list and click Replace or a blend percentage to blend it with the current values. If you want to immediately put your transform presets on a shelf, you could use the Store Transform Values bonus tool. This makes it handy to apply a preset to a character or hierarchy when you want to return to a pose, a bit like applying stored poses and action sources in Softimage. For more information, see Stephen Rosell's video Maya Bonus Tools Store Transform Values. There are also some other bonus tools that you may find useful to accomplish different transformation tasks. The Mirror Translate Rotate tool, the Randomize Transforms tool, and the Proportional Transform tool. In the next video, we'll look at the object pivot, alignment, and matching transforms in Maya.